Hello, I'm Dr. Jimmy Douglas, and in this video, you'll be learning about pregnancy testing. It's important to diagnose pregnancy early in a sexually active woman so that early prenatal care can be provided and harmful medications, alcohol and smoking can be stopped. And if the pregnancy is unwanted, then counselling regarding termination of pregnancy can be provided. As you all know, the signs and symptoms of pregnancy, which could be any of those listed, but these could be due to many other reasons as well. In PCOD, you may have missed periods. Nausea and vomiting can be due to many other reasons too. But we want to know if the woman is pregnant or not. After sexual intercourse or sex, here you can see the sperms deposited in the vagina go through the uterus and reach the fallopian tube, where they meet the egg and fertilization takes place. The whole process for the sperm to meet the egg takes place in a few minutes. If pregnancy occurs or fertilized egg implant, then the embryo secretes beta hCG, that is beta human chorionic gonadotropin, into the blood. And some of the hCG is passed on into urine. And we are detecting this beta hCG in the urine by commercially available pregnancy detection test kits. You could get these kits from the local pharmacies, also known as urine pregnancy test kits or UPT. So let me simplify it. How do pregnancy test kits work? A test strip is made up of absorbent paper, contains antibodies in the testing portion of the paper strip, which react with beta hCG in the urine and gives the colored line, indicating a positive test. The C or control line makes sure that sufficient urine volume is used and is internal procedural control to make sure that the test is valid. How to use pregnancy test kit at home? While you check the expiry and make sure you have all the things ready, the sample taken is midstream first void, first morning sample, as it has the highest amount of beta hCG. So how do we take the midstream sample? Firstly, pass a smaller amount of urine into the toilet and then start collecting your urine into the urine container. Do not touch the inside of the container. After collecting the sample, finish passing the urine into the toilet. Place 3 drops of urine into the sample space, yes. Leave the kit undisturbed for 3 to 5 minutes and then read the result. Reading the UPT test results at home. Positive result. C is the control line, T is the test line. First, we should see that there is a colored line in the C region after every test. It implies that the test kit is working fine and is valid, and then we'll proceed to reading the results. If both lines are seen, then it's positive. The lines may be dark pink or purple. The colored band on both C and T indicates test is positive, meaning the woman is pregnant. And here, when we say that the test is positive, it means that beta hCG is detected in the urine. If only one line is present, that is, if only C or control line is C, then it's negative. The absence of colored band in T region and presence in C region indicates that the woman is not pregnant. Invalid test. If the colored band does not appear in both the control and test region, then it's an invalid test. If it's invalid, then try again with another card. Other scenarios which you might encounter are, you may find a faint line at the test region. Reasons are, if you check too early, the beta hCG has not increased much and you could get a faint line. So repeat the test again after 3 to 4 days and check. If the woman checks even after 1 week after the missed period, the line they are getting is a faint line. The reason could be because of delayed ovulation, which led to delayed conception. Other reason is ectopic pregnancy, when the fertilized egg attaches somewhere outside the uterus, so the line will be light. It's an emergency. Missed abortion. The fetus got aborted but retained in the uterus and the fetus doesn't grow, and so does the beta hCG level also not increase. And we come to know this by ultrasound. Evaporation line. If the results are red after a long time, time given is mostly 3 minutes to 5 minutes. If red later than 10 minutes, then we get a line called evaporation line, caused when the urine evaporates and leaves a faint line which is colorless, or also called as a watermark line. So read the result within the reaction time. You have seen all these scenarios, but you need 100% confirmation that the woman is pregnant or not. So now let's see how blood test in pregnancy works. Pregnancy can be found out earlier by blood test than by urine test. Beta hCG is released as early as 8 to 9 days post-fertilization. It means beta hCG can be found in the blood before the first menstrual period. So what we are checking in the blood is the levels of beta hCG, that is beta human chorionic gonadotropin. Normal values in non-pregnant women is 10 milli international units per milliliter. In pregnant women, beta hCG values double every 1.4 to 2 days, that is 48 hours, reaching a maximum level between 60 to 70 days of pregnancy. Later, the concentration slowly declines in later months. So you get the blood report of beta hCG and reference values are there, and in the reference values you can see the weeks of gestation corresponding to the beta hCG level. So what do you infer from the blood report? Is the woman pregnant or not? So what do you infer from the blood report of beta hCG, which corresponds to a value of 3 or 4 weeks of gestation? So do we infer that the woman is pregnant? No, because beta hCG can be found in many other conditions like ectopic pregnancy, hydatidiform form mole or choriocarcinoma, pregnancy with Down syndrome, spontaneous abortions. Where pregnancy is outside the uterus, it's called ectopic pregnancy. Sometimes the pregnancy cannot develop normally, resulting in a hydatidiform form mole, which is just a mass of tissue. Lower levels of hCG are found in ectopic pregnancy and spontaneous abortion. And to overcome all the doubts whether the beta hCG is from the implanted embryo or it is from any other source in the body, so to be 100% sure, we go in for transvaginal ultrasound. Here the ultrasound probe is inserted into the vagina and visualized. Intradecidual gestational sac is identified as early as 29 to 35 days of gestation. Here you can see the gestational sac and yolk sac is identified by 5 weeks. Fetal pole and cardiac activity can be found at 6 weeks. So ultrasound is a confirmatory test. Ultrasound gives a definitive diagnosis and we can be sure that the fetus is implanted in the uterus. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.